Welcome to another reading vlog. Hi guys, so in this reading vlog, we are going to try to read a lot of books. I'll talk about my reading goals for the week right in the beginning so that you can figure out what to expect. Number one book that I want to read this week is Surprise Me by Sophie Kinsella, which is something that I read throughout the day and actually finished reading today. Number two book I want to finish reading this week is this, The Girl Who Played with Fire by Stieg Larsson. This is the second book in the Millennium Trilogy. It's a thriller, quite a massive one. So this is major work for me. Number three book that I really want to finish reading is Gunahon Ka Devta. I really intend to read this 250 pages book and make a video about it. So this is one of the Hindi classics. I'll talk more about it later in the video. And the last book that is on my agenda in this reading vlog is Dream With Your Eyes Open by Ronnie Screwvala. I'm listening to this book on Audible and we'll talk more about all of these books in this reading vlog. So let's get started. Hi guys, so today on Tuesday I have been listening to an audiobook called Dream With Your Eyes Open. It's written by Ronnie Screwvala, who is the founder of UTV. Like, he's in entertainment space and all that. Pro won't stop barking, so I'll have to tell you about this later on. Gunahon Ka Devta by Dharmveer Bharti. It's a Hindi classic and I have read about 30 pages and my Hindi reading is pretty slow. But I am going to work on it as much as possible. I should be like done with about 100 pages today if I was on track. But obviously I'm not. On Tuesday, I read about 30 pages of The Girl Who Played With Fire. I still am like not extremely impressed with this book, but I am 300 pages done with it now, almost like half done. So I am keen to finish it and then really finish the Millennium Trilogy. I also have been reading Dream With Your Eyes Open on Audible, listening to it on Audible. And I'm about like 3 hours left with it, but I got this idea from a friend yesterday. So here's the thing. I was really discussing about how I read Atomic Habits, right? And then I'm listening to this book also, but the impact is not so much. And he, who is an avid audiobook listener, suggested to me that when you're listening to audiobooks, you often tend to get distracted. Sometimes you just start thinking about something else and those words are running, but you are not processing those words. And also, you are normally multitasking, which is why sometimes you might miss some ideas. So you have to just re-listen to the audiobooks. And I feel like that makes sense. That won't be a waste of time, especially when it comes to books that I really found valuable in the first time. Because honestly, I actually save time by listening to audiobooks. So if I even have to give double time to a book because I'm listening to it twice or maybe 3-4 times, then also I am doing my reading, I am learning something new. Because he was also like, whenever I listen to an audiobook, he, by the way, is listening to the Harry Potter series since last 2 years, and he finishes the series every month and he starts it all over again. So he has been like, I always find something new in it, and I always used to think it's maybe because it's just Harry Potter series and that's why he finds something new. But then I thought maybe that's not the case. Maybe it's just how audiobook listening is supposed to be. So I'm trying out that idea in a way that I'm going to finish Dream With Your Eyes Open and then restart Atomic Habits and just, you know, play these 2-3 books on loop until I am satisfied with them.
So on Wednesday, I have finished reading another book, Percy Jackson and the Demigod Files. This is a companion novel and I did not like it at all. I gave it 3 out of 5 stars. Honestly, I feel like I'm not a very, you know, like passionate Percy Jackson fan. I liked Percy Jackson novels. I loved Heroes of Olympus series. But this book is it didn't feel so good to me. Moreover, it has a collection of short stories and some trivia for the fans and also some exercises to just check how good a fan you are, which obviously didn't interest me much. But I finished reading this book, so that is like 2 books finished this week. I honestly am working on, you know, actually finishing up the books that I had started for a long while. For example, this Percy Jackson, I had read about 60% of it and today I read the rest of the 40% and got done with it. So that's a big thumbs up. I also started reading another book on that I acquired from Kindle Unlimited. So these books are basically free because I have the Kindle Unlimited subscription. The book is called Your First 100 by Meera Kothand. It is really about getting your first 100 customers and stuff like that. This person is sort of like into email marketing, and I'm an online marketer, so I just thought of checking out this book. I have read about 40-39% of it. I mean, it's okay, I'm reading it, I have a few highlights in it, but let's see what happens with this. But yes guys, this is what I've been reading on Wednesday of this week. Reading vlog on Friday, and the update is on Wednesday I downloaded this book. I actually downloaded a lot of books. I'm just like Kindle Unlimited shopper, because you know I don't have to spend some money, but I can still shop and actually get books. So I got this book called Purane Gunah Naye Gunahgar by Surendra Mohan Pathak. Now if you don't know, Surendra Mohan Pathak is considered one of the legendary authors of Hindi literature, and he has written several books, and this is his first novel, and it was available for free on Kindle Unlimited. I was like, let's get it, and I got it just for like my window shopping thing. But I just flipped a few pages on my Kindle, of course, on my Kindle Paperwhite. I flipped a few pages and I was so impressed, so I ended up I think doing 40% of the book or 30% of the book in one sitting, and now I'm at about 46%. So yes, I have started reading another book. I also finished another book, which I'm not sure I told you about, but I have finished Percy Jackson and the Demigod Files. So these are two books that I finished in this week, which is fantastic. I'm telling you, if I am able to finish even one book a week, I will continue doing my reading vlogs. Not finishing even one book a week, it makes me feel like, what was the point of the reading vlog, right? So I kind of like refrain from posting the reading vlog if that happens. But if I continue finishing one book a week, which I intend to, I'll continue with my reading vlogs. And just seeing you guys so happy with the reading vlogs, I'm like, Manpreet, you are an evil person to not give them what they want. So I'm gonna try my best to make more reading vlogs, but yeah, this is going good. So today is Saturday and I finished reading another book, which is like amazing, because in this week itself, this is my third book that I have finished reading. And the book is Purane Gunah Naye Gunahgar, which is the first book of Surendra Mohan Pathak. It's a Hindi book. And honestly, I picked up Surendra Mohan Pathak because A, I was looking for a Hindi read. B, I was looking for something simple and, you know, something I could pace through because my Hindi reading is not that fast. And C, because I wanted to take on like a big project, something like reading Agatha Christie or deciding to read all the books of Agatha Christie, because they are a lot, and you know, it gives me a sense of like good feeling, I would say, to be taking on such a project, even though I think we all know how I'm going to fare at it. Anyway, I finished reading this book. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. Honestly, it's not something quite astonishing in a good way. It's simple, it's short, it's about this reporter Sunil, and there are more books in the series of Surendra Mohan Pathak featuring Sunil. So this reporter gets a call from this woman, and this woman tells him about her father, who is accused of bank robbery and is currently in jail. And she's like, my father is not the person who conducted this robbery and all that. And so Neil somehow falls into all of this, and he has to figure out really whether the father or this girl actually are innocent or not. It was pretty small, so I think that is one of the reasons why I could you know, read it in such a less time. But really, I read it in 3 sittings. Okay, in the first sitting I read more than 40% of the book, I think, and then 2 more sittings and I was able to finish the book. So I am really happy with this one. Give it 4 out of 5 stars as a very beginner in Hindi literature. I mean, I am pretty sure if somebody who has been reading a lot of Hindi books, if they review this, then they would have maybe lesser ratings. Even I would, as an English reader, would give lesser ratings to an English book, maybe. But you know, as a beginner in Hindi literature, I really liked it. I have also started reading another book called 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Now this is a very popular, but at the same time, there are so many people who just want to know the 7 habits. It makes me go crazy, okay? I know most of the people are like, this book is 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, so if I know the 7 habits, I don't need to read the book. And this is partly the reason why, you know, like, I don't like the book summaries, because they just tell you
Seven Habits and a little introduction about it. But even if you read the foreword of the book, it talks about how it's not really the seven habits that are really important. It's about why they are important and the stories and the reasons the author gives you that make a difference. So yeah, I am pretty sure if I talk about this book, a lot of people are going to talk about and be, what are those seven habits? Why don't you just tell those? There's no point of me telling those. You would be better off not even knowing the habits if you're not going to read the book. But anyway, I am 11% done with it. I don't know how my progress would be. Honestly, for me, this week wasn't really about, you know, finishing books. Yes, in a way it was. I was trying to go through a few books that I was reading because they were, for example, surprised me. I think I started reading it in April. I do not remember exactly, but it's a way too long time to be reading a book, and you know, being 60% done with it, I could really finish it. So this week I really focused on, you know, finishing something. By the way, I started reading another book. I do not remember the name, but I'll tell you about it. I'll put it over here. So I returned this Purane Guna Naye Gunagar on Kindle Unlimited, and I saw the store and on the top this book was there, and I started reading it. It's a 62 page book and I will be reading it, but honestly, the guy didn't give his introduction. Okay, seems like a blogger and investor. I saw the Twitter profile and everything. Seems like a person popular in his genre, but dude, you're putting it on Kindle Unlimited. Not all the people are going to know the celebrity you are. At least give your introduction and tell us what you have done. Even something like I'm reading Dream With Your Eyes Open by Ronnie Screwvala, and he is a big entrepreneur and quite popular in India. And still, he gave like a full introduction. I have never ever read a self-help book which is about lessons a person has drawn from their life without an introduction of the person. So it's just like, I'm like, you have written a book but no introduction of yours. So what is the point behind that? Because then he keeps on talking. Then what annoys me even more is that he keeps on talking about how I would know he wasn't investing like this for 2 years. Dude, I don't know. He never told me. It seems like a bunch of blog posts just combined together and, you know, gotten approved by the Kindle team to be put on this platform. But really, it has gotten 321 reviews at this moment, I think. Like hundreds of reviews and it's on the top, but two basic things are missing, which really is, I think, to be noted here, that anybody can get on top of Amazon listings and everything. Doesn't really matter the book is good and even the reviews could be like played with, because honestly, I don't see like all of these reviews, all of these 4-5 star reviews. People didn't notice that the guy didn't give his introduction in the book. The guy never told you what he has done before telling you lessons he has drawn from what he has done.
In the end of this vlog, let's wrap up what I have read. Okay, number one book, which I was recently talking about, this Stocks and Stuff. So I do have it on my Kindle, Stocks and Life by Abhishek Kar. I'm 25% done with it. Still super annoyed. I mean, just the lessons, there is no context. Just, you know, you should do this and do that. And I have never seen a self-help book that would help out in that way, okay? Nobody really, like, even books that give little context, I hate those kind of books because they really do not help. And this is with no context, okay? Like, seriously, chapters are 1 to 2 pages long, which I appreciate because they're small, but time is money. And, you know, talk about why time is money and all that, why you shouldn't watch TV and all that. But where is the context? There's no context. He talks about how he learned this in a specific way, but how? Like, when are you going to tell me that? You're never going to tell me that. So this is like a really, you know, disappointing read, and seriously was on the top of Kindle Unlimited recommendations. Unbelievable. Also, if you are an Abhishek Kar fan, I really see people getting like boycotted or cancelled on Twitter just because they choose to say something that people do not like. So I'm not really, you know, doing it deliberately, honestly. I am a person who is really looking forward to learn more about stock market investments and everything, and I really did expect something good out of it. That was the reason why I downloaded it, not only because it was on the top, and it is missing the basic stuff. So I am disappointed. That's just it. Number two book that I'm reading, and I'm 11% done with it, is another Surendra Mohan Pathak book, which I downloaded yesterday. Samundra Mein Khoon. This is the second book in the Sunil series, and he has a lot of books in the Sunil series. So I'm going to be picking up and reading it in the next reading vlog, which, by the way, if you haven't subscribed to me yet, please do subscribe for more bookish videos. And I also have read 12% of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People and 39% of Your First 100. Honestly, Your First 100 is again something that I'm not liking much. I feel like I would be soon tagged as like bloggers ka dushman, enemy of bloggers, because it seems to me like I'm not trying to support them, but I am. I really want to support them if they are ready to give me decent content. And lastly, I am about 300 pages done with this. Honestly, I feel like if I want to make more progress with it, solid progress with this book, which is now very interesting, okay? Now, like, for a moment I got disconnected with the book, but I am now again into it. But the friction of it, that I have to set up my camera and then read this book, that is just making me stop reading, which is so not cool. And Gunaon Ka Devta, I read about like 20 pages, but the language is, I mean, I would be reading it, but right now I feel like I'm more into Surendra Mohan Pathak. So sorry, Vishal, I tried reading it. I read about 30 pages, but then I was like, half of the lines are something I'm not able to understand, and I'll have to ponder over them for like 10-20 minutes. And I could do that work, and I tried to do that, but not right now. Right now I'm like so much into Surendra Mohan Pathak. So please let me read that, and then we'll get back to Gunaon Ka Devta by Dharamveer Bhatti. And yes guys, these are all the books that I've been reading. I'm pretty sure I missed one or two, but yeah, we'll talk about it in the next reading vlog. So if you like watching this reading vlog, please make sure you hit a thumbs up, a big fat thumbs up, and also subscribe to this channel, because that really helps to support this channel. And also, if you want to check out any of the books that I mentioned in this video, links are down below in the description. If you use my affiliate links to buy anything from Amazon, that also helps to support this channel. So yes, thank you so much if you decide to support this channel, and thank you so much for watching this reading vlog. This is Manpreet signing off. I'll be back with another vlog very soon.